So I was thinking of talking to you more about sampling, but it seems like it might work out best to just have some hands-on experience with it, so we're going to put those things on the homework. So given that, we're actually in a position now to kind of wrap up the whole Bayesnet inference piece that we were talking about. So do you want to help remind me, Charles, what were the things that we covered?
Sure, I can help you with that. We covered Bayesian inference. I'm sorry. I'm punch drunk.
I'm going to choose not to pay attention to that. Instead, write Bayesian networks. We talked about the Bayesian network representation of joint probability distributions.
Right. And we did a lot of examples of how to actually do inference with networks. You know, exactly how do we compute probabilities of particular values. We mentioned sampling.
That's right.
And then we did a naive Bayes.
Well, first we did say that in general, it's hard to do exact inference. It's actually hard to do even approximate inference.
Mm-hmm.
But we talked about a special case of Bayesian networks that was called naive Bayes, with the naive part being that we're assuming that attributes are independent of one another.
Condition on the label.
Right. And this was actually helping us make a link between all this Bayesian stuff, that Bayesian rabbit hole that we went down, and classification, which is the core machine learning topic that we've been spending a lot of time on.
So the other thing that I really liked about this, with this notion, this link to classification, Michael, is that when I was talking about Bayesian learning, right, what we ended up with at the end is this nice idea that we had a gold standard, right? We had a sort of way of talking about what the right hypothesis was and ultimately what the right classification was by computing these probabilities. And sometimes we couldn't do it because typically you can't actually do the for loop that requires you compute conditional probabilities of hypotheses given data over, say, an infinite number of hypotheses. But at least we kind of knew what the right thing was. And if we made right assumptions, we could do things like derive a sum of squared errors or various other things that you might do. And that was all very cool. But what you've done here when you do inference is, at least with the naive Bayes case, you've shown us a way that we can do classification using these things that actually is tractable and is the right thing to do under certain assumptions. So I really like that. And the other thing that I think that's worth mentioning is that not only does it link this Bayesian learning to classification, but it connects classification back to this general notion of Bayesian learning and Bayesian inference, where you don't have to worry about just figuring out the most likely label given a bunch of attributes, but because it's a Bayes network and you can compute anything from it, you could try to ask, well, what's the likelihood that I see some particular attribute or set of attributes given a label or given a subset of attributes, and on all those kinds of things that you could do with Bayesian learning. So inference gives us this power to not just do classification, but to do a larger set of things beyond classification. I think that's kind of cool.
Cool. Yeah, well said. Another thing kind of in that same space is that it handles missing attributes really well. So whereas things like decision trees and so forth, if you give me an example that doesn't have one of the attribute values and you hit that part of the decision tree where you need to know that attribute value, you're stuck. Whereas in this naive Bayes setting, you can still do the probabilistic inference over the missing attributes because all the things are linked by probabilities.
Nice.
All right. So I think, you know, you'll get a much stronger handle of this when you go through the homework problems. But I think that's enough for Bayesian inference. And I think that actually wraps up classification and regression more generally.
Right. So we're done with supervised learning. Well, one's never done with supervised learning, but we're at least done with this part of the course.
Because there's always more to supervise learn.
That's right. And in particular, you'll get a nice example of this because you'll be taking an exam.
Okay.
And your input will be the exam, and then we'll give you a label back.
I guess that's one way to think about it.
Well, and then they'll get to generalize beyond that for the next time they take the exam.
Very good. All right. Well, thanks very much. This has been fun. Thanks, Charles.
This has been fun. I will see you on the second mini course.
All right.
Bye.